Today we're here to celebrate a very special occasion. This is the opening of the 5th Malo Mchelezo project. As you know, the meaning of Malo Mchelezo is place of refuge. The reason for this new project is the very sad situation. It's the murder of 2 young women who were willing to give their lives in order to love others. Their names are Anita Grünwald.
My name is Anita.
And Rita Stump. Today in our midst we have the mothers of these 2 girls. Thank you for coming.
Wenn dein Leben so sinnlos scheint, dann bin ich da. Ich bin bei dir, auch wenn du es nicht glauben kannst, auch wenn du es nicht fühlen kannst, dann bin ich da.
Ich hab's nicht verstanden. Ich hab auch gesagt,
I didn't understand it at all. I said, Lord, I don't understand it at all. Where were you? They had the best intentions. They were eager to serve you. And where were you at that moment? But I also said, especially now, I will hold on to you.
Erst recht halte ich an ihm fest.
Anita's and Rita's Church, the Baptist Church in Wolfsburg. This is where their spiritual education began. They are cousins. Anita's and Rita's parents are originally from the former Soviet Union, like many members of the congregation. From Wolfsburg, they started into the world, working for social projects. Rita went to Kazakhstan. Anita worked as a nurse in Malawi, Africa. Together, they headed for a hospital in Yemen. After just 1 week, they were hijacked and killed. What kind of people were Anita and Rita? What did they believe in? And how can a murder in Yemen become the cornerstone of an orphanage in Africa?
Anita
was a very happy person. She loved her life. She was very aware of life. She was very grateful, rather quiet, but very happy. We had many happy moments together. everyday moments like breakfasts or walks or just sitting close to one another. In winter, our open fireplace was one of her favorite places. That's where we sat quite often, chatting or just reading.
Das war so auch ein Lieblingsort, wo wir gemeinsam saßen, entweder uns unterhalten haben oder einfach nur gelesen.
Klar, mein Wunsch war, dass sie.
I wanted her to find a husband, to get married, to have children. We had even made plans, half in jest. She liked that. And sometimes, when I hadn't mentioned it for some time, she said, "Dad, what's wrong? Why don't you tease me anymore about getting married?" And I said, "Go on, get married. If only you have a partner, someone to protect you."
In church, when I look at the choir, I keep looking at the first row. That's where Rita used to sit. When she came in, everybody could hear her coming, and with a boom, she sat down. She sang and served with all her heart. That always opened up my heart.
Das hat mich immer gefreut.
Also Anita war.
Anita was smaller than I. I kept teasing her about that, because she is the older one. I called her my little sister.
Ich habe immer gesagt, meine kleine Schwester.
Sie hat so wunderschön.
She had lovely hair. I was always a bit jealous of her curls.
Anita war eher ein bisschen zurückhaltend.
Anita was a little shy, rather like me. She kept more in the background. But she was very considerate.
Hat an jeden gedacht.
When you talked with her one day, she came back to that the next day. She really took seriously what you had said.
Sie hat es wirklich ernst genommen.
Sie war sehr aufgeschlossen.
She was very open and always very kind to people, even to people who were not very friendly.
Nicht so freundlich kam.
Ich erinnere mich immer in der Küche.
I remember that we had a lot of fun together, like dancing in the kitchen to salsa music. I can still hear her laughter.
Ich habe ihr Lachen immer noch so im Kopf.
Die beiden Mädels, wenn sie zusammen waren, vor allem, die haben sich irgendwie.
The characters of the two girls complemented one another.
So in ihrer Art und wirklich Rita eher so eine offene, die.
Rita was outspoken, very down to earth and very positive. And Anita was the one who contributed the deeper thoughts.
Einen irgendwo da abgeholt hat mit wirklich lebensfrohen Dingen. Und Anita war dann halt eher diejenige, die dann dem Ganzen irgendwie eine Tiefe gegeben hat.
Sie hat jedem alles verziehen. Da.
She forgave everything. She never held a grudge against anybody. And she was very willing to help.
Nachgetragen hat und hilfsbereit. Sie war sehr, sehr hilfsbereit. Also sie hat alles stehen und liegen gelassen.
She left everything behind to help other people. She was very generous, and that's what I always admired.
Bewundernswert und sehr vorbildlich.
Wo sobald einer in der Ecke stand.
She noticed it when someone was left behind, when somebody was sad. Even if you couldn't tell from the outside. Then she tried to cheer that person up by writing a postcard or a text message or calling on the phone. That was her special talent, that she was very loving.
Dass sie sehr, sehr liebevoll war.
Solange ich mich erinnern kann, hat Anita schon immer ein Herz.
As long as I can remember, Anita loved children, especially poor children. There were a lot of pictures of African children in her diary. She often wrote, "It's my deepest wish and I hope it's God's wish too, that I can go to Africa."
Glücklich mal nach Afrika zu gehen.
Then, after her high school, she started her training as a nurse. And while she was still training, she was looking for ways how she could go to Africa. That's how she found the ICW, the International Christian Worldwide Mission. With the ICW, she went to work in Africa, in an orphanage in Malawi. And when she came back, she said that she wanted to go there again. She said, "I can't help it. I must pass on the others the love of God, which I feel."
Ich bin von Gott so geliebt und ich kann einfach nicht anders. Ich muss es weitergeben.
Ich denke, Anita war es sehr wichtig im Glauben, ihren Platz in ihrem Leben.
For Anita, it was very important to find the place in life which God had intended for her. She was praying and reading in the Bible, trying to find out where God wanted her.
Wo Gott sie haben möchte, wo Gott sie hinstellt. Und ich finde, dass sie.
For example, she had a good and secure job. She was a qualified nurse. She could have started to work for the medical service at Volkswagen. But in spite of all that, again and again, she gave up her job to go to Malawi to help poor children.
From then on, she was determined that she wanted to work full-time for God. She said that it didn't have to be in Africa. She wanted to go where God wanted her to go. And she realized that she needed to know more about theology, because she wanted to tell people about God. Coming back from Malawi, she was at home for just 2 months before she went off to her theological seminary. For 3 years, Anita and Rita studied at the Protestant Bible Seminary in Brake in northern Germany. They studied the Bible, attended prayer groups, and did community work. On the campus, there are two paths to commemorate the two former students, symbolizing their two lives, joined together in a circle. On the benches, people can pause and think. On either side, there is a tree.
Es sind Quittenbäume, die blühen sehr schön.
We chose quince trees. They have very nice blossoms. For us, Anita and Rita were a gift from God, like a blossoming tree. But quince trees also bear fruit. That's why we chose it. We trust in God that He will transform their fate into something good. That even in Yemen, they have left traces. That in some way, they will not fade away completely. But what we learn from them is also what can happen when you try to bring God's love into the world. You will encounter not just thankfulness, you will also encounter resistance. The early Christians knew that. For us, it's a challenge. We are shocked because we forgot that. Sometimes, when we look at pictures from our student days at the seminary in Brake, we come across pictures of Anita and Rita. Suddenly, they appear on the screen. Then all the joking stops. People become very quiet and they start thinking. They start remembering that they were really wonderful friends. I was amazed how she did grow during her time in Brake. I mean, spiritually. How sure she was when it came to difficult parts of the Bible. Topics where it's possible to have different opinions, where even scholars have different opinions.
During her first summer camp at Brake, she called and said, "Mom, there's a girl at the camp. She is addicted to drugs. I talk to her a lot. Please pray for her." So we joined her in her prayers. And shortly after that, we got a text message. The girl has started believing in Jesus. After Rita's death, we got a letter from the girl's mother. She wrote to us, "You can hardly imagine what your daughter meant to our family, how our whole life has changed after this summer camp." It's in moments like that that I am speechless.
Up to that day, I was not a Christian. I was always amazed how strongly she believed in God. From the time when she was a little girl, right up to her death, I kept asking myself, what is it? What draws my daughter so strongly to the church, to God? I never understood that. And she wanted me to go to church too. That was her dearest wish. She often said so and wrote it in her diary. I have now read it. She wrote, "I fast every Monday for example breakfast, in the hope that Dad starts believing in God.
Hauptsache, dass Papa zu Gott kommt.
Also, ihr Glaube, muss ich sagen,
her faith became deeper and deeper. Even I learned a lot from her.
Sogar von ihr viel lernen.
Anita ging nirgendwo in Ausland oder irgendwo.
Anita didn't go anywhere without her parents' blessing, especially not abroad. My wife always agreed with what Anita did, but it was up to me to say yes or no. I still remember we were here in the living room and I said, Anita, why Yemen? Because Yemen is a foreign country to us. We were standing there, right in front of the fireplace. I could have said no, but she wanted my blessing.
The Al Jamhuri Hospital in Sada, North Yemen, a state hospital run by a Dutch Christian relief organization. This is where Anita and Rita plan to spend the last practical course of their student time.
Am Anfang gleich, wo es hieß Yemen, sag ich Rita.
At first, when they mentioned Yemen, I said, Rita, why Yemen? Then they didn't mention it for a while. But then it was Yemen again. Rita, I said, it's so dangerous there. But Mom, God is calling me.
They prayed a lot, asking God if that's the road they should take. First they prayed alone, then together. There were other opportunities, but in the end it was always Yemen.
Es führte immer wieder zu Yemen, immer wieder dahin.
Ich habe echt.
I kept saying, why do you have to go there? A couple of days before they left, I had read an article about people being kidnapped in Yemen. I confronted her with it. I didn't understand at all, why they wanted to go to a country like that.
Ausgerechnet in so ein Land gehen muss. Also bei mir war das so, als Mensch.
I must confess, when my sister told me, I didn't really know a lot about Yemen. Almost nothing, really. That's why I didn't realize where she was going. And also, Anita was often abroad. That was just another trip abroad.
Also ein weiterer Ausflug, sag ich mal.
Sie sahen in jedem Fall die Not der Menschen dort.
They realized the misery of the people in Yemen. They had made contact with the hospital. And they realized that they can both be of help there. Anita with her medical training and Rita with her training, which could be useful in the administration of the hospital. They went there knowing that they could be of help.
Und sie fuhren beide hin in dem Wissen, dort werden wir gebraucht.
Je näher der Termin zum
Wegfahren. When the day of their departure came closer and closer, my husband worried more and more. And I said to him, they have already bought the tickets. They are looking forward to it. And it's not an adventure holiday. They know where they are going. They have asked God and many people for guidance. Let's not sadden their hearts now.
God ruft.
God is calling. We must go. That's what she said. Many people tried to talk them out of it. I was the only one who didn't. And frankly speaking, I don't regret it. I saw that they knew what they were doing and that they knew why they were doing it. And when they were already on their way, when I drove them to Brake, then Anita said, I'm glad that we are going together. And Rita said, me too. And then I asked them, do you have no doubts? And then Rita said, no doubts, but scared shitless.
Kein Bedenken, kein Zweifel. Dann sagt sie, Schiss habe ich schon, aber kein Zweifel.
The hospital in Sada was built up by a Dutch couple, both of them doctors. For 30 years, they and their team lived through tribal feuds, drug wars and civil wars. They always treated the wounded of all sides. They trained local people in medicine and they worked hard, operating eyes and teeth and bones. They helped countless mothers to give birth. Their motive, Christian charity. Most people in Yemen believe that all Europeans are Christians. The idea that there might be non-believers in the world is completely strange to them. Some people thought that surely we must be Muslims, because we were such nice people. Often we were asked, do you pray? How often do you pray? That's natural in a conversation in Yemen. And when you're invited home, you talk about everything. In the Western world, talking about religion is a taboo. But Muslims like to talk about it.
Taboo subject, aber in die Muslime sprechen sehr gern und natürlich davon.
When we arrived in Yemen, we put on our scarves to cover our hair. That was strange. It's difficult to get used to women who are completely veiled. They all look the same. You can't see the individual. Wearing our black scarves, we started off towards Sada, where we will spend 2 months. We saw high mountains on the way, very dry regions and houses which had been destroyed. Sweating all over, we arrived in Sada. In 2004, the so-called Houthi conflict started. That was a civil war in our region. A group of Shiite rebels were fighting against the government. But we never felt that we would be a possible target for the rebels. And also we thought that in a war, there will be many injured. It's not right to abandon the hospital in that situation. On Friday, 12th of June 2009, a group from the hospital went on a little field trip. They had done that before, but this time it was to be a journey into death. Anita, Rita and a Korean woman were shot and left behind. 4 others are still missing.
Und dann auf Weg zurück.
They were already on their way back, about 1 kilometer outside of Sada, when 4 or 5 men in a black Suzuki Vitara blocked their way. 2 or 3 hijackers took our Toyota Land Cruiser and then both cars drove away. People said they saw the cars driving away, but we don't know where they went.
Ja, weggefahren, dann haben noch Leute die Wagen gesehen, aber wo die dann ja endlich hingekommen sind, das wissen wir nicht. Und dann am Montag sind die dann angerufen und
on Monday we got a phone call with a message that 3 bodies were found.
Drei Körper gefunden, so das Team war ganz erschüttert.
Our team was devastated. And then members of our team had to identify the bodies. That was terrible, because the bodies had already been exposed to the hot weather for 2 or 3 days. It was very hard for the team to identify the girls. We were told that the girls were blindfolded and their hands had been tied up with a rope.
Die Mädchen hatten eine Augenbinde und auch die Hände.
All three were shot right next to each other. There is no evidence that they had tried to escape. They were executed.
Versucht habe zu fliehen oder es sieht aus wieder. Ja, die sind hingerichtet.
Das war so ein Durcheinander oder die Nachricht allgemein.
It was pure chaos. I was shouting. I was ranting.
Ich habe geschimpft. Ich habe auch geschimpft.
Where was that God whom Anita loved so much, whom she tried to serve? Where was God at that moment?
Auch gedient hat. Wo ist er geblieben?
How can he let something like that happen? I ran outside. I shouted. I cried. It's not true.
Bin rausgegangen. Ich habe geschrien. Ich habe geheult. Das kann nicht wahr sein.
Ja, bei uns herrschte hier auch.
It was extreme. Our world had collapsed.
Zusammengebrochen. Ich glaube, der erste Tag, wo man es erfahren.
When we got the news on the first day, all we did was crying.
Der Tag danach.
And on the following day, we just sat there and couldn't react anymore. We didn't have any tears left. And we lived through the day as if in trance. I think that was even worse.
Ich glaube, das war noch schlimmer als der Tag davor.
Ja, wir waren ganz.
We were all shocked. We just sat there for 20 minutes or half an hour and cried.
Nur gesessen und geweint.
Ich bin dann zu meiner Frau nach Hause gefahren, die die Nachricht auch schon gehört hatte.
I drove straight back home. My wife had already heard the news. She was weeping openly. We sat together for some time. And then we started praying. It was extreme. I have never experienced anything like that.
Wer ist hier?
Everybody tries to handle situations like that differently. That's just how it is. I often took the car and drove around on my own. Sometimes I went to the cemetery, shouting, crying. I had to get it out of my system. Then it was easier. And always my thoughts kept coming back. What had they done to them? Inside, I almost broke down. The black thoughts come back automatically. Those were really hard times. Like a roller coaster. Sometimes up, sometimes down.
Menschen erklären sich bereit, den Ärmsten der Armen zu helfen.
They were willing to help the poorest of the poor. Not to preach, but to do charity work. That kind of thing doesn't happen often in the world. And the people in Yemen, they need that so much. And these people, whoever did it, they didn't appreciate that. And without any reason, they kidnap and kill people.
Grundlos entführen, töten.
Ich war wütend. Ich war sehr wütend.
At first I was very angry.
Und auch
angry at her and angry at myself because I let her go.
Dass ich sie überhaupt gehen lassen habe. Bei mir war die Wut mehr auf,
I was angry at God, because he sent her there. Anita saw this as her calling. And I thought, that's really mean. And after 1 week, they got murdered. At first it felt unreal, not quite comprehensible. Rita had often been away before. But this time it lasted so long, and slowly I became more and more aware of the fact that she won't come back. In this world she doesn't come back. It's in moments like this that it really hurts. It hurts badly. For months and months you think it will all be over soon. And they will be back. Their laughter, their happiness, their enthusiasm, their dreams.
Diese Visionen und Träume. Alles wird wieder so sein, wie es mal war.
Everything will be as it was before.
Aber so nach nach einem Jahr.
After the first year, the feeling of being helpless makes room for reality. They will never come back.
Dass sie nie wiederkommen.
Nein, man weiß ja nicht, wer es war.
We don't know who did it, so it's difficult to say if I hate them or if I would like to do the same thing to them. So that's not what I'm thinking. But of course I have a certain aversion to radical Islamists.
Andersgläubigen gegenüber den radikal Islamisten.
It's really hard to love them. I know you should love your enemies, but in this case it's really hard.
Schießt dann manchmal so durch den Kopf. Was würdest du tun, wenn du...
Sometimes the idea does come into my head. What would you do if you met this person face to face?
Aber dann besinne ich mich halt immer darauf.
But then I think again and remember what Jesus taught us in the Bible.
Und diese Leute, die
and the people who did that, they will get what they deserve. The punishment will be just. So I stop thinking about that.
Gerecht sein und deshalb denke ich da nicht drüber nach.
Also ich denke auch nicht an die. Das, ich will mir die
I try not to think about them. I don't want to imagine what kind of people they are.
Denk ich nur darüber,
it's only when my parents talk about it that it comes to my mind.
Ich kann gar nicht denken an die Leute.
And I don't think of revenge either.
Und sowas nicht.
Viele Leute sagen, dass
some people say that political groups which are interested in restarting the civil war could have been involved. Others say that maybe it was just criminals, drug traffickers, or arms dealers, or religious fanatics. But that are just rumors.
Aber das sind alle Gerüchte.
Ich bin bei dir, auch wenn du es nicht glauben kannst. Auch wenn du es nicht fühlen kannst, dann bin ich da.
Ich habe sie noch nie versucht.
I have never tried to imagine the girls. But after their death, there was this flash when I was running. It was not a dream, it was real. They appeared in the sky, laughing and scattering flowers. It was gone right away. That's only a fraction of what we will see. It's like the Bible says, it will be greater than everything our eyes have ever seen and our ears have ever heard.
I have seen Rita twice in a dream. The first time she came up to me with a book in her hand and I said, Rita, you are here? And she said, yes, why? Where should I be? And where is Anita? Anita will be here soon. Then the dream was gone. And not long ago, Rita was passing by in a hall. I said, Rita, and took her into my arms and tried to hold her. Oh, Mom, she said. Then she broke free, or rather, she just slipped from my hands and disappeared.
Mir entgleitet ist einfach raus und ist dann wieder gegangen.
Dann habe ich geträumt, dass ich
I dreamt that I was sleeping. Anita came to me and said, Jenna, wake up, it's just a dream. Then I woke up and saw all the pictures of Anita and realized that it wasn't true. That was awful.
Ganz schlimm für mich.
Immer öfter, als sie nach Hause kam, hat sie davon gesprochen.
Coming back from Africa, Anita had often said, Mom, please pray with me. I would like to start an orphanage so much.
Aber mein Wunsch ist einfach,
I wish I could pass on the love of God to all those children who grow up without love.
Zuneigung, diese Liebe weitergeben.
That was her vision. Her friends would tell you the same. They had a wonderful circle of friends. In the end, they shared her dream. Anita had the ability to inspire people.
Sie so angesteckt hat alle. Sie konnte anstecken.
Also ich freue mich sehr über dieses Kinderdorf, das dort entsteht.
I'm very happy about the orphanage. That will always remind us of them.
Man immer wieder so daran erinnert wird, an die beiden.
Und so Projekte wie jetzt das Afrika.
If you look at the Africa project, it might sound strange, but to an extent it was worth it. God has turned it into something positive.
Mein Wunsch war, Anita Traum erfüllen.
I too wanted to make Anita's dream come true. It's a great joy for me personally. And I never thought that it would come true so quickly. There is so much support, so much dedication. Anita was always crazy about children in Africa. Now, having been there myself, right there where she had been, I understand. You can help everywhere. And these children, what a smile. And for an embrace, you get ovations.
Applaus sozusagen.
On the first Sunday in Advent 2010, 1.5 years after the murder, the orphanage Mdeka was officially opened. It was built with the help of donations in remembrance of Anita and Rita. In its final stage, there will be 100 children in the orphanage. Godparents in Germany pay for the food, clothing, medicine, secular and religious education.
Ja, dieses Kind hier, das ist Isabel, Isabel Patrick.
This is Isabel Patrick. She was the first child in our project, the first child we visited at home. She lives close by in Mdeka, just 10 minutes from here.
Am Projekt, also sie hat 10 Minuten Fußweg hier zum Projekt. Der Grund, warum wir sie besucht haben, ist...
She is one of the many orphans in Mdeka. She has lost both father and mother and lives in a very difficult situation. She lives at her grandmother's house, but her grandmother doesn't have the means to support her. Her grandmother makes home-brewed beer and tries to sell it. So Isabel comes from a very difficult background. Everything was very dirty, and there was a very strong smell in the hut. She has kind of a bed with a few rags to sleep on. It was all very poor. A very difficult situation for her.
The first 15 children will be taken in today, officially registered. And starting with tomorrow, we will be taking care of them.
Awandiana, amene ana kila masertifiketi, omwe.
The start of a new life for Isabel Patrick.
Ich denke immer, ich mache jetzt das, was...
Sometimes I think, what I'm doing now is what Anita would have wanted to do so badly. That's when the pain starts coming back. But on the other hand, I am very grateful that God has given us this task. Sometimes I think it's too much. It's hurting too much. But all in all, I'm glad that we have this wonderful mission.
Dass wir diese schöne Aufgabe bekommen haben.
Ich gucke immer wieder mal hoch, wenn ich hier auf dem Projekt stehe.
Every now and then, I look up to the sky. And I try to imagine what they would say if they could see us now. I think they would rejoice.
Anita und Rita werden nicht vor Gott stehen und fragen Gott.
Anita and Rita will not ask God Why did you take us away? It's the opposite. They are glad to be in heaven. For me, that is comforting.
Mir hilft, dass ich weiß, dass es ihr jetzt besser geht als...
It helped me to know that she is better off than we are. In the end, mourning is a kind of egoism.
Eine Art Egoismus, sage ich mal, weil...
Something was taken away from us. We miss something. If you think about it and see it through Anita's and Rita's eyes, then they are 1,000 times better off. 7 times 70 times better off.
Mal 70 mal besser als wir. Wer weiß, wie viel besser als wir.
For me, there is comfort in that.
Das gibt mir Trost.
Und das hat mir nochmal einen anderen Blickwinkel auf meinen Glauben gegeben. Also es ist etwas, was mein Glauben nochmal auf ein...
It has opened up a new perspective on my own faith. It has made the foundations of my belief even stronger. For me, it has been the proof that faith in God is stronger than the most extreme situations, stronger than the hardest challenges.
Die härtesten Proben bestehen kann.
Es war wirklich für sie keine Sackgasse.
It was not a blind alley. Seen from above, it was a chance to change something in a positive way. And they achieved that.
Und ich glaube, das haben sie erreicht, das haben sie getan.
Ja, das glaube ich auch.
That's what I believe as well. It was not a wrong decision. It was the road God had meant for them, and they chose to take it.
Den Weg Gottes, den sie gegangen sind, den sie wahrgenommen haben. Ich denke, die wollen...
They would want us to be happy, to enjoy our lives.
Spaß am Leben haben, ne?
Natürlich kommen auch die Tränen mal, wenn man so... es fehlt was.
There are still tears. We miss her.
Ansonsten dieses... Diese Gewissheit.
But I'm certain that we will celebrate a reunion someday. Maybe tomorrow, who knows? I get a lot of strength out of that.
It helps that we can comfort each other and cheer each other up. We often talk on the phone with Anita's mother. Sometimes she's doing well and I'm not. Sometimes it's the other way around. We can encourage each other. And I just don't know how anyone can cope with the loss of a child without faith in God. It must be unbearable.
I hope she can see that I go to church now too.
Ich glaube sehr fest an ein Wiedersehen.
I firmly believe in a reunion. That's what God promised in the Bible. He assured us of it.
In der Bibel. Ja, hat uns das zugesichert.
There is hope in this. Hope that helps us through the days.
Ein Stück Hoffnung, was uns durch den Tag hilft.
Even in the midst of sadness, there's joy. Yes, we will see her again.
Ja, dass es ein Wiedersehen gibt.
I'm looking forward to that.
Ich freue mich drauf.